All right, so it turns out it matters how we select training examples when a learner is needing to learn. So let's at least articulate some various ways that training examples could be selected, and then for each one we might end up with a different answer as to how much training data is going to be needed if the training examples are selected in that particular way. So what do you think, Charles? Are there any ways you can think of for selecting training examples?
Well, so I here's how I think about it. So you keep using the word learner. And when there's a learner, there's often a teacher. So I'm trying to think about this in the different ways that learners and teachers can interact. So I'm going to try to think about my experience as a professor. So there are a couple. Here's one. One is sometimes the learner asks questions of the teacher.
I see. So in this case, the learner would be selecting the training examples. The learner would say, here's an input X. Would you please tell me C of X?
Right. That's exactly what I'm thinking. Right. Then there's another case. So the learner asks questions of the teacher, but sometimes the teacher just goes ahead and gives X, CX pairs.
And let's say it actually is trying to help the learner.
Sure.
So it's a friendly teacher.
Okay. I've had some of those.
Good. All right. So it could be the learner asking to try to get data. It could be the teacher asking to try to lead the learner to something good. And anything else?
Well, so I like this way of thinking about it because it sort of makes sense in my world as a professor, but it doesn't actually sound like either of these things is what we've been looking at so far. What I think we've been looking at so far is that somehow the X's and the CX's, the training examples, just come out of nowhere. They come from some underlying distribution. It's just nature. It's just coming at us from some process, and we don't know what that process is.
Yeah, I like that. So in some sense, there's three individuals that could be asking for examples. There's the teacher, there's the learner, and there's like the world around them. And the things could come from any of those. I guess another possibility would be that questions are asked specifically in an evil way. All right, so all of these different kinds of distributions or ways of selecting training examples are actually going to come into play in the stuff that we're talking about. Let's use the first couple to get a sense of why these things might be different from each other. So let's go back to this notion of 20 questions.
Okay.